Let's move on to drawing lines. You can follow along by loading up 1.3.03 demo drawing lines. So first let's get started up as usual by declaring and initializing a shape renderer. Also, we gotta remember to clean up after ourselves and get rid of anything we're not using. Also note, instead of using application listener, we're using application adapter here. Application adapter is just a convenience implementation of application listener. It stubs out all of the required methods with implementations that don't do anything. So all we've got here is actually create, dispose, and render. All right, as always, all the interesting stuff happens in render. So first we clear the screen, and then we start a new shape renderer batch, this time using the line shape type. All right, now we're gonna draw a line from 0, 0 to 100, 100. Let's give it a try. Well, that didn't go according to plan. There's nothing on the screen, and we actually got an error down here. Let's see, illegal state exception, call end before beginning a new shape batch. Oh, right. So all we did here was start the batch and then draw a line, but didn't end the batch. Then next time render got called, we tried to begin a batch, but shape render was already in the middle of a batch, so we got a crash. All right, let's try this again. Awesome, we're in business. Let's try something more interesting. Let's try drawing a line of a different color by using shape renderer set color and then using one of the predefined color constants. Then we'll draw another line slightly offset from the first one. Whoops. Well, we got our magenta line, but the first line we drew also ended up magenta. The way colors work with shape renderer is it'll assume you want white until you tell it about some other color. However, if you tell it about some other color, it'll retroactively assume everything you wanted to draw before that you wanted to draw that color as well. Let's try this setup. Hey, there we go, that's what we were looking for. We can also set colors using RGBA values. Now, before we draw this line, what color is this? So it's fully opaque, because alpha is 1, so that's good. All right, there's no red, and there's no blue, so the line must be green. Let's run it and see. Our predictions were correct. We can even do fancy things like drawing lines with gradients by specifying the color at the start of the line and the color at the end. And there we go, we get a nice fade from blue to red. One more useful thing for drawing lines. If we wanted to draw a whole series of line segments, it would get really tiresome to draw each one individually. So we also have Polyline. Polyline takes an array of floats, where the floats at the even positions are the x coordinates, and the floats at the odd positions are the y coordinates. If we give this one a try, we see this crazy path with a bunch of connected line segments.